Hello Aquarius, how are you today? We are here with the Ultimate Cross Watchers video. This was requested by some of my subscribers. I want to welcome all new visitors. Thank you for stopping by. I hope you enjoy your time here, and I want to thank all my subscribers who entered the contest for a free 20-minute phone reading by liking, subscribing, sharing, and commenting. Here we go. What is the overall energy of your person of interest and how they feel about you here and now? Ooh, you are on their minds, Aquarius. You are on their minds. So I really want to make this clear that general readings are all timeless, to be perfectly honest, by tarot philosophy. Also, too, readings are 0 to 6 months unless we specify otherwise, but it can take 0 to 12 months for things to unfold, and sometimes even longer. Treasure Island, look at that. Wow, this is a beautiful beginning of your reading. Your person just thinks that you are pretty magnificent. You are a treasure. Beautiful energy. Round and round, okay. Merry-go-round. Ouch, that one hurt. That one didn't feel so good. Here and now, okay. So that's what's happening. The person wants to deal with something within your relationship right now, and they want to show you the love and respect. They think that you're incredible. This person has probably been in your life for a long time, and they have been some sort of a merry-go-round to you. So let's look and see what your person's energy is in the recent past regarding you. What is Aquarius person's recent energy regarding your connection? Oops, there we go. Ooh, Seven of Pentacles, assessing the situation. Taking stock, trying to see where things are, trying to see if the investment in the relationship, sort of trying to figure out if you might invest with them or what it would take to invest in a relationship more. You've known each other a long time. You don't get to the Seven of Coins unless you have. Look at the Strength card. This is the Strength card, has the Infinity symbol on it. And I feel like, you know, when I'm looking at situations and I read for my clients, this really is about a relationship that is multi, you know, you've been together multiple times. It's not traditionally thought of as a soulmate card, but I see it almost as even a stronger one because you have decided that you adore each other, you love each other enough to go through a lot together. The Strength card lends way. Look at this beautiful energy. This person is holding on to hope. This person is trying to heal. This person is really feeling much gratitude. They have a blanket. They would like for you to join them on this beautiful picnic in life. And look at this string. They're trying to use a string to hold on to the sun, which is totally impossible. But it really speaks to the person seeing you as being beautiful inside and beautiful outside. All right. You are part of their family. The, you know, when we have Strength card, that's Leo energy. This is Aquarius energy. There you are in your own reading. This person sees how brightly your light shines. You are virtually their sunshine. When we look at the Seven of Pentacles, we're really looking at Taurus energy. It's that assessment time, you know, but that was in the recent past. All right, but when we look at the Pride, we know that this person considers you part of their family emotionally. All right, look at how they feel about you. They want to rush in to talk to you. They may be driving by your place, but this person is trying to keep their act. They're trying to be effective because if you notice, this driver would topple right off and be, you know, injured very seriously if they don't keep their horses in check. If they don't have the horses running at the same pace, if they aren't staying balanced, this could all come apart. And that's how they view you, that they better handle you with care. That is how they see the situation. What do they feel in their heart space for you? The Chariot is also thought to be Cancer energy for some, Uranus or Aquarius. All right. What do they feel in their heart space for you, Aquarius? Three of Cups, they feel as though you're their best friend. They feel as though you have a friendship again. Look at how beautiful this starry night is. Look at these cards. This is incredible. And with all this purple, that's, you know, and lavender, that is a very spiritual journey that you have with this person. Beautiful. You can also burn lavender candles to heal. All right. What is this person? How does this person see the situation moving forward? Ooh, wow. The Empress card, pure love and some emotional difficulties. This person is this person's underwater with you. The Moon card is Piscean energy. They're very confused. They feel very at risk. They feel as though if they tried to have a relationship with you and their own emotional problems pulled the relationship down, that they would truly have this sense of drowning without you. They have trouble with light and dark. They have trouble with the shadow side of their personality. You represent everything that they love, adore. You are radiant. You are beautiful. You are life-giving. You are Gaia. They want to come to you. They plan on coming to you. They'll come to you at night. They would like to wake up with you in the mornings. They would like to have a life with you. They would even like to have children with you. They want to create and co-create with you. Okay, so what is the hidden energy here with this person about you, Aquarius? Oh, King of Cups, the Scorpio King. They will love you till death do us part, whether you're together or not. Again, this relates very much to this card. When we look at the King of Cups energy, it's fixed energy. Leo is fixed energy. It doesn't change. Aquarius is fixed energy. Sometimes it can be stifling because you need a change. And yet sometimes it feels like there's no relief. That when this relationship is good, it's glorious. And when it is bad, it's hell, heaven and hell. You feel like you're drowning. All right, so the Scorpio King loves you, adores you. Life and death issues haunt this person. Scorpio King will love you forever. Let's see what we have for what's going on and the way that they feel right now about the situation, what they'll really do. They feel as though we have red light, green light, yellow light. Something has happened in your relationship to make them take pause and try to assess where this relationship is. So you have somebody, you know, they're building something here. They're co-creating, this group of people. And so your person is trying to figure out how to co-create with you. This also can indicate a third party situation in which we have a big yellow light, a big light of caution saying, you know, be careful what you say, be careful what you do, because this can unravel. All right. Let's see what the outcome is for you, Aquarius. Before we clarify, we're going to clarify everything. Clarifiers can virtually change a reading. So I invite you to stay and see what the outcome is. This person wants to live with you, has visited you in your home. This person wants to, this is really the penultimate celebration of stability. This can be the bridesmaids. In this case, it's tambourines, you know, people celebrating, but there's a big tent over here. In the Rider-Waite deck, there's a castle in the background and a bride and groom dancing in the foreground. But this is very, very typically the bridesmaids cards. This is also the bride, this is a bridesmaid card. This is a marriage card. All right. Traditional tarot philosophy anyway. All right, so let's look and see what your clarifiers say. What is it about this relationship that makes you this beautiful treasure island? I don't have my glasses on. I really need my glasses, man. Sorry about that. All right. So let's see, why are you this person's beautiful treasure island? Look at that radiant picture. They feel as though you glow, and look at this. She's looking at this, or looking away, but this person wants to put you in this beautiful castle. The Nine of Pentacles, right now you are very much single and free and competent and capable. The Nine of Pentacles is a beautiful, abundant woman who can take care of herself. The Four of Swords indicates that there's something needs to be healed in this relationship. There was a betrayal, and there's no healing until this person comes to you. The Queen of Pentacles is reversed, so right now you are most likely withholding any affection from this person. You probably don't want to see them until they tell you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. That Knight of Swords needs to come in and make a confession, and this person will do that. And I would say it could be at the time of Gemini, but it also could be when Venus in Gemini, because that's a Gemini card, goes forward at the end of July. The Hanged Man. Yep. I would say that this person is just really trying to look at things from your perspective, trying to really get a hold on their emotions. The Justice card indicates that they treated you unfairly, that they were blindfolded. The Four of Pentacles are still holding on to you. Yep, this is a treatment unfairly. Look at this. You were doing nothing. You were just taking a walk in the park, and this person was involved in something that really hurt you. The Five of Swords is when it's sort of like for no reason either. That's ego-driven. Swords are ego-driven. And it's intellectually they know, and it's usually because it's Libra energy. They know that they were totally unfair to you. You didn't do anything. You're standing over here like, you know, hey, this is me, and it's something that happened behind your back. Look at this, went on behind your back. So swords are communication, so it's oftentimes text messages or gossip. This is a terrible gossip card. All right, so why is there this beautiful, well, I wouldn't say the round and round is so beautiful, but it keeps you together. The Strength card, see, again, you will go round and round with each other through the millennium of life. I want to see what here and now is. What is this here and now card? Why? This is a here and now crisis is what the person sees. The overall energy is there's a crisis currently going on. The Ten of Cups is a happy family. The Ten of Cups reversed means that somebody violated the happiness in the family. Somebody violated, and there was gossip among family members. The Ten of Cups is happily ever after. This person would like to marry you, and they don't have the courage to even sort of, that's hallowed ground, that sacred ground. And instead, this person has wounded you. You are their happy place. The Sun card is Leo energy. Leo energy. There's so much strength in this bond, but this person can't manifest it, and they see themselves being to blame. But they also feel very assured that the two of you love each other enough that you'll get through this period of time. The Judgment card, though, is reversed, so it shows that they've wounded too many times, this has happened before, and that you're not going to forgive so easily. So that is their energy in terms of what they think is happening. Why is the Seven of Pentacles here for our beautiful Aquarius friends? Six of Cups. That is a soulmate card of the Minor Arcana. It is somebody who loves you, who's very tender, who's very sweet. You might have known them since childhood. The Page of Wands. They have a passionate desire for you that they've had since they were 13. Just saying. Passionately found you beautiful and attractive. Four of Wands. Oh my gosh. They feel as though they should have married you. They definitely have remorse and regret. They are looking at the situation, trying to see now if it's something you would even consider. If I invest, will my Aquarius, would they ever marry me? Would they ever marry me? Would they give me that level of trust? The Queen of Swords says, not today, folks. The here and now. No way. And rightfully so, because the Queen of Swords is the Judge Judy who seeks the truth. And with this backbiting, and this defiant, destructive behavior for no reason other than there is somebody in the situation here who wants to hold on to this person, who pretends, again, justice card with the Libra Queen, you know, that somebody, that we have a bad queen here, the Queen of Pentacles. There's a Queen of Pentacles that jumped in here and interfered. The Four of Swords really doesn't want this person to want you. Oh, the Hermit card. This person's been alone without you for years. Oh, boy. Oh, so somebody's very manipulative. All right. So you have a third party that isn't romantically involved. But, boy, are they emotionally invested. They are rushing in. There's so much jealousy here. Oh, whoever the Queen of Pentacles is reversed is really jealous. And every time your person wants to come to you, this person rushes in and tells them all the reasons they shouldn't do it. The Chariot card. But they want to rush to you. They want to come over. I would actually say they've been driving by your house. The Two of Pentacles, they're of two minds. The King of Swords, oh, they're a perfect match for you in many regards. Because both of you can view situations intellectually and survive them. Absolutely. Okay, why does this person want to rush in right now? Mm-hmm. Well, the person thinks that to make love to you is the solution to this problem. Well, that's what they think. That's what they want to do. But, you know, at the end of the day, they're carrying a burden. They feel really guilty. All right, and so, yep, they really were wasteful. Look at this person has literally earned three coins, and then in an act of just sheer boredom, this is usually a wonderful card, but in this instance, they had their coins in a paper bag. They didn't value those coins enough. You don't put coins in a paper bag. That's ridiculous. And this person's just letting them go plink, plink, plink on the sidewalk. Again, this person is overly influenced by third-party situations in which friendship and the claim of value in those relationships. But it's very toxic, very toxic. Yep, the Ace of Coins indicate that the people who are toxic around this person that are interfering in your relationship, it's a female, but who actually has a seizure. The person for whom you've come to this reading to discover information about, is it really shows me that this person wants, actually has an attraction, would really wish. There's a real jealous factor here, very jealous factor. Even if this person, the Queen of Pentacles, is likely married to someone else, this person's highly invested in playing sort of mind games. You know, the Piscean energy is secretive. This is Pisces. Oh, secretive, 12th house, unraveling. This person is a bit unraveled. The person you're dealing with is a bit unraveled. And the situation is definitely unraveled. It's a kind of thing that can really break people emotionally. All right, but look at this. You are strong. Page of Pentacles. You know better. You know better than to fall into that trap. All right, so the King of Cups, and your person knows that. They know that about you. All right, so the King of Cups here, oh, feeling guilty. Seven of Swords. We won't say the rest of the words. Four of Swords, you can't heal until there is a flippant apology. Look at that. So we have the Five of Swords, until they come clean with you, until they stop keeping secrets, until they make an apology, there is no movement forward. Again, we have the Three of Coins. And remember, the Three of Coins is up here. Where is it? Is that right here? Yep. They wasted. Oops. I don't know where what did I do with the Three of Coins? Is this it? Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, I just showed you the person with a bag on their head, right? And the Three of Coins indicates that there's something to be worked out. This Three of Coins, you know, instead of letting coins drop onto the ground, you need to be productive. This person absolutely needs to make that apology. The other person needs to make the apology, but I don't think they're going to be very interested in it because they're toxic. Let's see, what is the situation as it's going to unfold? Eight of Pentacles, you will get the apology. I would say that you may get it as late as September, maybe even around the 8th. It could also be August. The Star card, oh, ho, ho. The Star card, this person cannot live without you. They know it. They can be as cold and aloof as they want, but this is Aquarius energy also, so it could be you, but indicating that for any healing to happen, there better be an apology. And until there's an apology, there is nothing to talk about. All right. Hierophant, there's a desire to marry. There's a really strong urge to marry on this person's part. Too many marriage cards to ignore. Just too many. All right. And why is the Hierophant card here? They see you as a beautiful Queen of Wands, fiery, sexy, incredible, you know, a good orator. You boss up. You rule. Oh, the High Priestess card. You are, you are absolutely a rock star. Unbelievable. You are spiritual. She's holding the Torah here by traditional standards. But you define the way you express your spirituality in a very sort of goodwill towards mankind. Why is the Four of Wands here? The Magician card. They are trying to manifest you. They're hoping that you'll reach out to them, but this person has their hands in their pocket. There's no text message coming. There's no emotion coming. That Magician card is actually you. They're trying to manifest you, and you are just going to ignore the heck out of them. You know, here we have the Eight of Swords. So when you go from the 5 to the 7 to the 8, you are off. You'd rather go shopping. Let me go shopping. And I'm throwing you away until you maintain some sort of equilibrium and come forward in a realistic way. All right. So this is just one card I'm going to pull. This is going to be about how you can best handle the anything that would be anxiety, you know, for you. This is for healing. This is to help you deal with this very stressful situation you're in. So what is Spirit going to tell us for this? Imagination, conjure, dream, and create. So whatever that means in your life, whether it's baking a pie, writing a novel, or imagining a new way of life for yourself, you are golden. You're very strong. Beautiful energy, Aquarius. Please let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you. Bye-bye.